my God. Oh, my head.
Answer me that. Just answer me that! Your own family. Your own blood. What the hell were you thinking? What in the hell crossed your mind?
No, no.
The fuck is happening
to
you?
This can't be happening. God.
You ruined our family. What am I gonna do now?
I have to find the handle.
My son! You are not my son!
Come on. Maybe I can get out through Grandpa's house. I gotta get out of here. I need to find a way out. Before Dad notices me. Wasn't there a door here? What the hell has Dad been doing here? Dad said he was repairing Grandpa's house, but instead he's been investigating this woman? What is going on? My notebook? So Dad's the one who took it away from me. I don't remember drawing any of these. Am I going insane? Grandpa's house. Been here since he died. Fuck. This storm must have taken out the power. I think Grandpa had a generator in the basement.
From the moment of first contact, it is already too late. When a demon attaches itself to a human, it becomes a parasite of sorts. It feeds from the host until it devours every last part of their soul. In most instances, the demon's relentless objective is to get back to the world of the living. If you want to break that link, well, I'm afraid it's no simple matter. I could speak at length about various rituals and procedures, but by far the best way is to obey. Help the demon attain that which it seeks. Only then will the demon leave of its own accord. Usually they enter the earthly plane through certain objects that they use as conduits between worlds. Even if you rid yourself of that object later, the demon has made the contact it needs, and already walks among us. In the first stages of possession, the host human tends to withdraw from friends and family, becoming aggressive, even violent. This is the result of the spiritual battle between the host and the entity, both vying for control over the mortal body. The symptoms that indicate that the possession is progressing are dizziness, nausea, and headaches, the latter of which can be so intense as to render the host unconscious for days. The dark entity manipulates its host with visual hallucinations and voices in the mind. Destroying the sanity of the host is for the purpose of making them malleable, compliant. This is how the demon fully exerts its insidious control. Oh, and before I forget, several cases of possession saw strange behavioral patterns in nearby insects. Cockroaches in particular. My advice, steer clear of the insects.
There's just no way. I can't be possessed. There must be a mistake. Those pictures, that leg, that arm, I didn't do it. Dad thinks it was me, but I... Oh, God. My head. A door. A red door. What's happening to me? Is this what that man was talking about? It can't be happening to me. Could it be the basement door? No signal. Ugh, it smells awful. The pipes must be clogged. Chains? Maybe I can break them with something. What? What is this place? This is impossible. What's wrong with me? Those symbols. I've seen them before.
Officer Russell here. June 17th, 1987, 5:27 a.m. I am now entering Madison Hill's basement.
Hill? 1987?
I can see there's a sort of well in the center of the room. Looks like it's open. I'm gonna investigate further, see what's on the other side of this. God, there's a horrendous smell coming from down here. Oh God, I almost can't take it. Time to make things worse so I can't see a goddamn thing down here.
Happening to me. I gotta get the hell out of. I don't understand. My head.
A 43-year-old woman was killed by a police officer.
The entrance key should be somewhere.
Grandma's diary?
Why would he keep all this? Grandma died a long time ago. What are these things? She was so sick. Definitely. Someone.
these photos are pretty old. Dad. Never got over her death. Too much already. Tried to contact Grandma with this thing? Is that blood? In this house. There are handprints on the walls. The handprints stopped. Get out. How did I get here? I hate graveyards. What am I doing? God. really deep. How did I end up here?
This is impossible. This place didn't look like this a second ago. The color of life, the color of peace, the color of our little angels. The color of death. The color of wine, the color of Jesus' blood. Was that the bell I heard at the graveyard? Son, Hale? Is this her coffin? The eye is missing. The color of the sky, the color of the sea, the color of Mary's tears, the color of light, the color of the sun, the color of our Father Lord. Hello? Excuse me.
Me again, Mother. Nancy. I did it. I I finally did it. You have to understand. It was like living with a monster. No, he never loved me. He was a liar. He lied to me. He lied to you. He lied to everyone. He was a liar. He lied to himself. He tried to pretend he didn't have the past. He did. He wasn't a vile, disgusting, despicable piece of garbage. You know, he just wanted to marry me, to get away from his crimes. He knew he couldn't stay in Germany. He knew his past was coming to get him. He knew it. He tried to pretend it was all gone, but it wasn't gone. It chased him. It haunted him. It haunted me. Father, you have to understand. He was in charge of a gas chamber. He took so many innocent lives. He destroyed them. Who could do that? There were days I would look into his eyes and I would see a void, emptiness, nothing looking back at me. He was already dead. Only God knows how many lives he had taken, but not anymore. I made sure he would not hurt another person. I made sure that he suffered. I know God will forgive me for my sins. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Our Father in heaven.
Another candle. My hand. What the fuck was that? I gotta get out of this place.
boring? Madison Hill, 1944-1987. Is this her skull? Sealed off. What? It's sealed off. What? The attic.
Priest Thomas speaking. I was able to finally get the information you asked for, and the truth is, I'm worried about your family. Generally speaking, demons try to complete simple rituals to break the bondage of their souls. To carry out this ritual, you must rid yourself of an object with important sentimental value to you. Offer it as a sacrifice. There were practitioners of witchcraft who became haunted as a result of their thievery and dishonesty. They used to steal jewelry from ancient dynasties as to avoid performing the sacrifice directly for themselves with their own sentimental objects. They bought the sacrifice with the emotions of others. But this perverse being is trying to go beyond even that. We are speaking of an ancient ritual, of which very little is known. Seven sacrifices, seven mutilations.
Seven?
I believe we are facing a body exchange type of ritual. Madison Hale was trying to complete such a ritual before she was murdered, and now she is forcing your child to finish it for her. She is trying to steal your son's body. Call me as soon as you get this message.
Is that what she's after?
Becoming possessed by a wicked entity is signified by a loss of control over the body, mind, and the soul. However, that is often not enough for the entity. It hungers for more. Things get much worse for the host. In these cases, possession is just the first step of the demon's plan. It is said there are those that return to our world seeking to resolve unfinished matters from their mortal lives. The victims of these wicked possessions are subjected to a departure of sorts. An astral transportation, for lack of a better word.
An astral what?
These malicious beings force their hosts to live moments that shouldn't be possible in a different place and time, perhaps even in a different dimension altogether. It's madness. It's unclear whether these transportations occur inside the mind, or if the host is physically taken to some alternative reality.
Alternative reality? I'm losing my mind. I should keep this. Thank you. think there's something else under that plank.
Thank you.
she mentioned in her diary?
God. My eyes. My eyes burn. God. I need to get out of this fucking house. Where did these come from? I think I should open it first. Body exchange ritual? I need to put an end to this. This is from Grandma's diary. There must be something useful here.
These must be Madison's victims.
Stress to you how dangerous these demons really are. I've witnessed a few exorcisms in my time. Not everyone lived to tell the tale. These beings are not alive, and that makes them stronger than us. They entertain themselves with it. They enjoy our fear, causing us pain. They feed off of it. It gives them power, gives them strength. When one of them becomes attached to one of us, it's all but impossible to stop. They play with our bodies and minds.
Does this mean that
until they find what they were looking for?
That woman is attached to
the camera?
They're
no longer human.
Attached to me?
They are beyond everything we know. John, I implore
you. She's no longer human.
Seek help. I'll investigate that woman you told me about. Madison Hale. And I'll get back to you as soon as I find something. Keep all of this information away from your son. Get rid of that camera as soon as you get this message, but please, please do be careful. If your child has already had contact with this entity, his life, yours, and your family's are
Mom.
In jeopardy.
Chanel, what have I done? I need to find a way to end this.
Fuck.
It burns. My body burns. Horns? I think I've seen something like this in the house.
How many times do I have to tell you there's nobody in this house?
Al?
I'm done with your bullshit.
Albert, listen to me.
Just a book. A fucking book, Elizabeth. See? There's no one here. It doesn't exist. It's not real, goddammit.
I know. Everything that's happening to me has something to do with it. I just know it.
It's a disease, Elizabeth. You are sick for the Lord's sake.
Not sick.
You'll end up losing your mind if you don't cut the crap. That book has nothing to do with your illness. I wish you stopped acting like a child. Stop hiding our stuff and take your goddamn pill. Jesus!
Do you think it's normal? Do you think pupils vanish like dust? I'm telling you that fucking thing is what's causing
Enough,
this for me!
Enough, Elizabeth! Stop acting like a 10-year-old and go to bed!
Albert! Everything started the day we brought that fucking book to this house!
It's a disease, Elizabeth.
If you don't believe me, I will leave this place. I'm done. And I'm taking Johnny with me. We are not staying here!
Wait a minute. This is way too much. You're paranoid, Ellie. It's 4 a.m., Elizabeth. You're still... Go back to bed before we wake up Johnny. Come on. We can talk about this.
You're gonna regret this. You'll end up all alone. Just you and your stupid fucking clock!
If you find this, do not listen. No, 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 not again. No, fuck. I can't feel my fingers. What is happening to my body? I don't know what this could mean. There was a red light, but everything was dark.
am I doing? The doorbell. I gotta get to the front door. I won't be able to go back. She's playing with my mind. There is no
rights she was carrying out, or if she simply took the photos to immortalize the events. According to official sources, the 43-year-old woman, Madison Hale, intended on murdering 7 people. Fortunately, the police were notified before she could carry it out, putting an end to the massacre after the 4th. Was found in pieces inside the well along with the other corpses. So far, his left leg and 3 fingers have not been found. The first victim was her own 75-year-old father. Madison mutilated his body in such a way that his face was unrecognizable. His body was found in pieces inside the well along with the other corpses.
Sounds like something's wrong.
The first victim was her own 75-year-old father.
Madison mutilated his body in such a way that his face was unrecognizable. His body was found in pieces inside the well along the road. The woman passed away due to great loss of blood. Hours later, Madison continued to mutilate her body before disposing of it. The second victim was her 71-year-old mother. According to police reports, Madison amputated both of her legs while she was still alive. The woman passed away due to the illness. Madison continued to mutilate her body before disposing of it. The second victim was her 71-year-old mother. According to police reports, Madison amputated both of her legs while she was still alive. The woman passed away due to great loss of blood. Hours later, Madison continued to mutilate her body before disposing of it.
On this one.
You.
old father. Mattis had mutilated his body in such a way that his face was unrecognizable. His body was found in pieces inside the well along with the other corpses. So far, his left leg and three fingers have not been found. The first victim was her own 75-year-old father.
You.
God. My body. My hands. This is what the priest was talking about. That thing is... thing is feeding off of me. What the fuck does this even mean? The house is full of clocks. Grandpa used to work in here. never finished this one. I can't take this anymore. I just can't. My whole body is going numb. Why is this happening to me? This must be a combination or something. To find the 4 digits to open this door. They must be somewhere. Room. I don't remember drawing any of these. Am I going insane? This used to be Dad's room. What happened in here? This is the book that everyone was talking about? The room has changed.
Thank you. Ah! Lights are lit.